Hello, good morning everyone. Thank you for being here today. This is Youssef Hennan speaking. I'm a PhD student from Lorraine University in France and Hassanda University in Morocco. I'm glad to be among you today to present you a study we made about drop-controlled islanded mesh microgrids. In general, microgrids with distributed generation units, DGs, is an efficient solution to reduce the greenhouse gas emissions because DGs mostly powered by clean and renewable energy sources. But because of the intermittency of these sources and the rise in energy demand, the interconnection between different DGs powered by different type of renewable energy, of course, is necessary. Firstly, for the independency of microgrids, as well as their power reliability. Which leads to the creation of more complex and mesh microgrids. Some of the most discussed issues in this matter are power sharing and synchronization. But the most proposed solutions, unfortunately, are only effective in mono-PCC type microgrids and not in multi-PCC mesh microgrids. The other problem that is largely discussed is the instability of microgrids due to the interaction between different types of DGs and loads. So in this paper, we intend to propose an improved control strategy for power sharing and synchronization in mesh microgrids, to propose and validate a mathematical model of the system in order to sensitize the controllers and for future stability analysis studies, to validate the proposed strategies by simulation using SimScape of MATLAB Simulink and by experimentation using hardware in loop real-time simulation by Opality and DSpace. What is drop control strategy? The classical drop control only intend to regulate for each DG the frequency and the voltage amplitude at the associated point of common coupling. So in this study, we decided to start by taking a drop control strategy that was proved effective in mono PCC type microgrid where the DGs and loads are connected to a unique point of common coupling and applied to a more complex mesh microgrid where the DGs and loads are connected randomly to different points of common coupling. This proposed drop control aims to indirectly control the voltage at PCC to be equal at PCC to be equal to its rated value. To see its effect on our mesh microgrid, a simulation is conducted by connecting both DGs to the microgrid at 0 second, and these two figures show the evolution of active and reactive powers of both DGs in per unit. In per unit, why? Just to see the participation of each DG. The used drop method leads to a perfect active power sharing, but the reactive power sharing is not ensured at all due to a coupling phenomenon caused by the line feeder impedances and the complex nature of the mesh microgrids. To solve this problem, a modified drop control for mesh microgrid is proposed, where the coupling between the exchanged active and reactive powers is removed by adding a nonlinear decoupling term to drop voltage equations here in blue. Ji varies with each operating condition and allows the primary control. And Vref is a reference potential corresponding to one of the PCC voltages in the studied mesh microgrids, and it is sent to all the DGs connected to the microgrid. The simulation result this time is different from the last time because in this simulation, only the first DG is connected to the microgrid at 0 second, while the second DG joins the microgrid at 5 seconds. The developed strategy ensures a perfect active and reactive power sharing after the connection of the second DG. But the problem is at the moment of connection of the second DG, a disturbing active power peak shows due to the lack of synchronization. Due to the complexity of the microgrid and the intermittency of renewable energy sources, DGs tend to connect and disconnect from the microgrid frequently. Therefore, an efficient synchronization strategy is required to ensure this plug and play function. To do that, the amplitude the voltage amplitude, frequency, and phase of the ESDG that wants to join the microgrid and its point of common coupling must be close enough or equal before its connection, of course. Therefore, a pure integrator controller is added during only during the synchronization period to the true control equation of this DG. The used, as you can see in these two figures, the used drop methods leads to a perfect active and reactive power sharing. Also, there is no active or power and reactive power peak at the moment of connection of the second dish, which proved the efficiency of the proposed synchronization and power sharing strategies. Second part of our study is to propose a mathematical model of the system in order to sensitize the controllers and for future stability analysis and this robustness analysis studies. Starting with the DGs, the state space model of a distributed generator contains four blocks: a power calculation block, a low pass filter in order to control the dynamic of the system, a drop control block, and a second order filter in order to imitate the inner control of the system. As for the microgrid structure, it contains two DGs, power entry classical and active loads, and active classical and active load, and a CPL load. The PCCs are interconnected by RLC power line. After citing all the microgrid component equations, this is the overall system can be described as follows. It should be noted that this model is nonlinear and with an order of 40. Before using the model for any type of study, it should be first validated. Therefore, a simulation is performed by applying the modified drop at the same time and under the same conditions on the same Simscape model and the mathematical model in MATLAB editor. The evolution of active and reactive powers in the two models are the same, which shows the validity of the proposed model, and therefore its eligibility to be used in future studies. Finally, the hardware in loop real-time simulation. To conduct this experiment, an NIPXI system is used to model the physical microgrid by a precise equivalent model that runs in real time. Its control is developed in this space, which is a separate system via its microlab box. The three-phase voltage generators representing the DGs are implemented in NIPXIE system thanks to three-phase inverters with their LC output filters. The control of these generators is implemented in the DSP system with a classical hierarchical control delivering the PWM signal. The cutoff frequency of the voltage outer loops have been designed to be equal to 100 radian per second. So the dynamic of the VSI control have been taken into consideration in this real-time simulations. As you can see in the experiment result, active and reactive power are perfectly ensured. There is no power peak at the moment of connection of the second DG at 50 seconds, which means validation of the proposed strategy by HEL real-time simulation. In this paper, we tried to show you the limitation of the drop control strategy that were proved effective in mono PCC type microgrids are and showed that they are less or none efficient in multi-PCC mesh microgrids. Therefore, we proposed modified drop control strategy that ensure active and reactive power sharing in mesh microgrids. We also proposed a synchronization strategy in mesh microgrids that doesn't affect power sharing and ensure plug and play function. We developed and validated a mathematical model of the system that is used to sensitize the controllers and can be used for potential studies. We validate the strategies by MATLAB simulations and by experiments using HEL real-time simulations. And thank you.